And just so you know, our policy that we put into place for the township has nothing to do with the Open Meetings Act. And just so you know, our policy that we put into place for the township has nothing to do with the Open Meetings Act. And just so you know, our policy that we put into place for the township has nothing to do with the Open Meetings Act.
I simply needed to point out, as I did at the previous board meeting, the woman named Susan Biscorner, who's currently on the board, or another committee, is a violation of MCL 15.263 sub 5, because it violates the agenda policy that was recently voted into effect, and there was a newspaper article written about how strictly it would be enforced. So
are you saying who violated the policy?
Mr. Ken Chartier, Clerk Lori Russelburg, Fiscelli-Lisco,
and Sandra Keais.
Yes, I explained this to them at the board meeting, that in order for an item to be put on the agenda, such as a new person being put on the Parks and Rec Committee, it needed to specifically be done by noon, 8 days prior to the meeting. Mr. Kyle Sunday was here 1 month ago at about 6:30 p.m., which obviously is afternoon, and there's no way that could have been put on the agenda by noon that day, because it didn't happen until 6.5 hours later. Therefore, the addition to the agenda was a violation of the Open Meetings Act. So, I mean, I just wanted the Parks and Rec Committee to know that there is an illegal person serving on board right now, and this is Susan Biscorner. So, okay. I thank you for your time.
All right, thank you.
And just so you know, our policy that we put into place for the township has nothing to do with the Open Meetings Act. And just so you know, our policy that we put into place for the township has nothing to do with the Open Meetings Act.